Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. First of all, a very happy new year. Today I'll be showing you how to install DevC on your Windows operating system, and then I'll also show you how to write a simple hello world program and how to run and compile them in our DevC. So let's begin. Now to install DevC, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar you need to just simply type DevC download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this sourceforge.net is basically our first search result. So just, you know, simply click on this DevC downloads, and it will going to redirect you to this official site of SourceForge. So you can see that we have a download button, so just, you know, simply click on that and it will going to start downloading after 5 seconds, and it has started downloading. So our latest version of DevC 5.11 TDM GCC 4.9.2 has started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can see that latest version of DevC has been rightly downloaded over here. Now to install, you need to just simply double click on it. And it will going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And it will going to start setting up our DevC++ installation wizard. So let us first minimize our download directory, and you can see that our installation wizard for DevC++ has rightly opened. So currently it has choose our language as English. You can choose any other language. I'm going to choose English only, and then just simply click on OK. And this is basically our license agreement. So always read that if we have time, and then just, you know, simply click on I agree. And under this choose component, these are the files and folders that they're going to be installed. So keep this all as default. So just check that you need to have 346.8 MB of free space in your C drive, so where your DevC++ is going to be installed. So keep this as default, then just simply click on next. And this is our installation destinations, C program files, DevC++ folder they're going to be create. If you want to change, you can always do that by just, you know, simply clicking on browse, and you can change your destination folder. But I'll be recommending you to keep this default, then just simply click on install. And it will going to start installing our DevC++. So this installing DevC++ will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after installing our DevC++. Yeah. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our DevC++ 5.11 is rightly installed. So our completing message is rightly there. So do check this run DevC++, and then just simply click on finish, and it will going to launch our DevC++. So our DevC++ first installation configuration window rightly open. So keep this as default, then just simply click on next. They are asking you that which theme you'd like to choose. Currently they have selected as this consolers. You can change it to any of the theme that you want to do. Right, so I'm just, you know, going to keep this default, then just simply click on next. And see that our DevC++ has been configured successfully. So just, you know, simply click on OK, and it will going to launch our DevC++, and it has rightly launched. So this is basically the interface of our DevC++. So just, you know, simply click on file, then new source file, and it will going to open a untitled file. So here I'm going to write a simple hello world program. So hash include stdio.age, and I'm going to just, you know, simply create a main method. So int main, then printf hello world. I'm going to end with a semicolon, and then I'm going to return 0. That's it basically. So now just again simply click on file, then go click on save as. It will going to open this window. Just simply create a new folder by just simply clicking on this icon. Make it as c-workspace. Just simply go inside that folder, give a file name. Let's give a file name as prog.c, because we are writing in C program. Then just simply click on save, and our program has been rightly saved as prog.c. And now if you just simply click on this compile and run, what it will do is it will going to start compiling, and then it will going to run in our console. See, our hello world has been rightly shown in our console. So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of DevC++ on your Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.